gorgeous people. So I'm back for a updated everyday makeup tutorial, I guess. I have not done a makeup tutorial on this channel in a very long time. So I'm gonna show you guys basically all of my favorite products and essentially how my makeup has been done for the past year. I don't know. I'm kind of like losing my words a little bit, but let's just do some makeup. So this is all of my makeup that I don't use every single product in here, but I use a majority of the products. I'm going to show you each and every product and kind of give you an idea of why I like it, why I use it. I got this bag a while back as a gift. So we are going to be using a couple of brushes. So a couple of sponges and a beauty blender. These are the tools. These are the tools that we will be using. I like my beauty blender. I'm about to wash it and get it clean. These sponges for my powder, and then these are my brushes. So these are the tools, the really necessary tools. I can do my makeup with just my fingers. A lot of the times I will do my makeup with just my fingers. I can also do my makeup with only brushes, but I prefer when I have a combination of everything. So I tend to get a lot of questions about primer, and I'm not gonna lie, I don't usually use primer. When it comes to skin prep, I think sometimes the best thing you can do is just put moisturizer on. So what you'll notice is, if you watch my makeup videos, I am very rarely using a primer. Most of the time I'm using some type of moisturizer. This is the one that I have with me today, and it's from Kiehl's, and I really like this. But if I were going to use a primer, this is really nice. I have to block out the light, but this is a Murad sunscreen, and it has like a silicone like finish. However, I love, absolutely love how this looks and how this lays on the skin. This looks so good under makeup, and it has SPF 50 in it. So I love it, it's so good. So I think maybe I should just show you. It's completely clear. A little goes a long way. And it feels so good on the skin. But like I said, usually I would just use a moisturizer, but lately I've been using this underneath my makeup, and as the day goes by, my skin just looks so nice and glowy, and it's like slightly mattifying. I don't know, I love it. I think it's really, really good. So that's what we got going on right now. So this is what I'm using today. This is 580 deep, medium deep neutral, and I kind of, I'm gonna put it everywhere. You do not necessarily need to use this much, but I don't think it really makes a huge difference whether I use a little bit or a lot. It just depends on my day, depends on my mood, depends on what I'm planning on doing that day. But you'll see that this just is such a good color on my skin. And sometimes I'll do what I'm doing now and I'll use my finger. Sometimes I'll use a brush. I do like a brush with this actually, but I just don't know where I put my brush. And then sometimes I'll use my beauty blender, which is, you are gonna see me use my beauty blender quite a lot, so. This is the point where I like to kind of take this little brush. This is a brush from Michaels, of all places. I use this brush for carving out my eyebrows. So I'm just kind of, it looks like I'm blending out the product. What I'm actually doing is I'm just putting product on my brush by like touching the rest of my face, and then I'll go and kind of trace out that shape that I want for my eyebrows. Do the top part with foundation. That's kind of been my MO for ages, so I like how that looks. And then now we can take a beauty blender and just start blending. And I love how this looks when it's all done. Oh, it's gonna look so pretty. And you see already my skin has such a nice glow to it. I did hear somebody say that they did not like the finish that this left on the skin, because if you use the wrong product underneath this, or if you have really dry skin, you might find that the product will start to peel off your face. I've never had that problem with this, but it's a possibility. So you guys see, it's just so, my skin just looks so good with this on. Now, if I did not have any dark spots on my face, like if, and when my skin is like completely clear, which usually is a few times a year, I will go in with just my Charlotte Tilbury. I love this product. This is the shade number 8. It is Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter. I have 2 of them. I love this so much. This one is almost empty, so I have a backup. I can't tell you how much I love this. So I can just put this wherever, and it's gonna just give my skin that incredible glow. This perfectly matches my skin tone as well. Like, for some reason, this Charlotte Tilbury is the exact color that matches my skin, especially during the summertime. So I will just put that on. And if I don't have any dark marks or anything, that's the only thing I use for foundation sometimes. It really just depends on the day and how my skin wants to act. Honestly, when I look at my skin right now, all I think of is Fayette. If you know, you know. If you speak TikTok, then you're my type of person, because if you watch TikToks like I do, then you'll know Fayette. Anyways, this is my concealer. This is NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer in the shade Amand. I love this. I'm gonna be using it under my eyebrows, on the sides of my nose, my upper lip, and I think that's gonna be it. But the first thing we're doing is carving out the under section of the eyebrow. I will say, when my eyebrows are good, like they are today, I don't necessarily need to do this part, but I'm gonna do it anyway. So I take my brush, I kind of coat it on both sides, and then we go in. I do like to take it down on the lid, because I always put powder on the lid, but I won't get into why, but you'll see in a minute. I always try to take my concealer down onto my lid, and I try to make them as symmetrical as possible. Okay, I think I did a good job today. So nothing that I do with my makeup is just like laissez-faire. My placements all have a reasoning behind them. For example, I'm taking my concealer right now and I'm putting it on the side of my nose. Why am I doing that? Because I do not contour my nose. So also, I'm taking concealer right here and I'm putting it on my upper lip. Why do I put concealer up here? Because if you were not, like, if you just, if I were to have a day and I'm like, I don't want to put concealer up here, what I notice that happens is if I put powder on my entire face, this section kind of gets a little dark looking, right? You need a little bit of highlight there to kind of balance everything out so this section doesn't look too dark, because if it starts kind of blending in and looking the exact same as everything else on your face, you don't add dimension in certain areas with like adding lighter products and darker products and whatever. If I didn't put this concealer here, which the concealer is lighter, and I didn't put a concealer here, and I just had everything be one tone, it's not going to give my face kind of the contour and dimension that I want it to have. And I'm hoping I'm using those words right. What I notice for myself is that when I don't highlight my upper lip, it makes me look like I have a mustache. So I always highlight this upper section just because I don't want that darkness from the powder that you're going to see, because I only really use like 2 to 3 powders. But it's like, if I don't highlight this part, it always gets a shadow. You see the shadow coming in the mirror already. That shadow is going to show through if I don't highlight that part. I usually like to have music playing, but I'm gonna just be my own music today. The music of my voice. All right, so that's the first concealer. Still haven't blended it out there, as you can see. What I'm about to do, and this is like one of many concealers that I have, so I'm gonna add a little bit of this Tarte. You see how bright that is? It's insane, but I like it. So that's what I'm doing. Adding the Tarte is going to bring that pop to the center of my face. And again, I do not contour my nose, so this reverse contouring is literally like a pinnacle of my makeup. Like, I have to reverse contour because I'm not taking powder and like contouring my nose afterwards. That's absolutely not happening. And even when you see me blend out my concealer, everything I do has a purpose. So I'll show you guys. Let's blend this side out first, and then I'll tell you exactly why I do it like this. So all right, before, after I blend out my concealer, I always take it up on top of my bottom eyelashes. For some people, they will blend their products out with a brush. When I have done that, I still have to try my best. Let's see if I can show you an example. Like, okay, so I blended this out, but you see how I didn't go on top of the lashes? There's a difference, and it's all about shadows. My eyelashes are showing through, and it doesn't slightly look like I have eyeliner on. If we're looking side to side, that looks like I have like something in my waterline, like maybe liner or something. So I will take, and I have to go all up into the waterline. And sometimes if I don't have enough product, I will even go in with more product just so I can do this adequately. We have to cover those lashes. And I mean, you can put mascara on later, but the point is I'm getting the product almost into the waterline. And I do that so that it doesn't look like I have like, you know, eyeliner on or something. And I just really prefer that look. So, this is the concealer. Doesn't take long, and it looks fayette. But you guys see, like, my skin looks insane. It looks so good. I can just eat it up. So for my powder, I'm gonna go in with like 3 powders. So I'm gonna be quick, but you just need to know why I do what I do. This is my face powder. This goes on my forehead, under my cheekbone, on my chin, on the sides of my nose, and on my eyelids. This is the same powder. This one is empty. This one is not empty. So what I like to do, since I have an empty one, you know, I will take the product, and I'm gonna try to show you the product. It's like chocolatey, that's what it looks like. It's like a chocolatey brown. I like to pour it into here. So I poured a lot into here actually. I did not mean to do that. And then I'll take one of these. I get these from Amazon. I will link them below. You get like a thing of 12 of them for like $3. And I tap this in. And I do that. A lot of people say, oh my God, it looks like you have eyeshadow on, or what eyeshadow are you wearing? I very rarely actually wear eyeshadow. I will take this powder and put it all on my eyelid. And I do one more thing after, but we'll get to that soon. But I take it, and you see, I do not like my eyelids being shiny, and I do not like eyelids that are like creasing and all that stuff. So I take this powder and I will kind of coat a layer or press a layer onto my eyelids so I don't have no problems. And then this part of my face always gets super oily. Even if I do powder it, it's still gonna get oily later. So I always take a little bit of extra and I put it there. And sometimes I will put it all over my lips too, but mainly we're just pressing it into the sides of the nose. And that's essentially my dark powder placement. Different placement for the light powder. And these are the products that we're using for the under eyes and for the upper lip. Now, these are different. Two of these are not the same. So, these two right here are called the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder for under eyes, okay? I use this for my under eyes and for my upper lip. I have shade number one and shade number two. There are only two colors, okay? It's either one or two. I like to use shade number two. And I have a couple of these. It is absolutely gorgeous. If you've used this product before, if you know, you know, it's so good. This is just a travel size translucent powder. I also have this from Pat McGrath, and this is just like a, technically it's like a powder for your under eyes, but it's just like a very well, finely milled powder. And this is in like medium. I might go in with this, but for the sake of the video, I'm only gonna use probably these two. And most of the time I only use this Secret Brightening Powder for the under eyes, shade number two. Shade number two, I'll cover it. It's peachy. It's like a peachy color. It's made for dark tones. Shade number one is white. Then this is just regular translucent powder. And so, it's a couple ways you can do this. I like to go in with one of these, and I'll just use the translucent powder first because I'm gonna be out all day, and I like to, I kinda wanna double layer this. So this is my first layer of powder. Again, the placement is done like this for reverse contouring purposes, all right? That is why I'm doing the placement like this, so I don't have to contour my face later, okay? I like to blend this out. I don't usually let it sit on the skin because there's no point, there's no reason. Then, all right, let me zoom in for this part. Then I'm going in with, no, these are the Secret Brightening, but this is the color I'm using. Shade number two, I like to use a brush for this, so I'll use this brush today. Now, the reason I like this, and you can't really tell, this has like a slight sparkle to it, almost has like a slight glitter. So it just looks so incredible. It lays on the skin so flawlessly. I have had these products for a minute. Most people don't talk about them. I never, ever, ever hear anybody talk about these products, but they are my like secret weapon for having really flawless under eyes. And I am absolutely obsessed with Laura Mercier. So this is a product that I recommend to most people. If you have super dry under eyes, you're probably not somebody I would recommend this to, but honestly, I say try it. Try it and see what you think, because a little goes a long way. It really, really, really does. So my makeup is almost done. Blush. So this has been the blush I've been using for the past couple years. I will switch colors sometimes, but honestly, this is the best color, because what you're gonna see in a second is that I use this for my lips and my cheeks. And there's also one other product I'm gonna show you. And it's this one from Kaja Beauty. I use this for my lips and my cheeks as well. So you can either do something where you like put this on, because this is a cheek product. The Kaja Beauty one is a cheek product. This product and this powder are essentially almost the same color. So that's why I like it. I'm going in with the same brush, okay? So this is called Intense. It's in the shade Intense. It's just like a really pretty mauve-y color. I do not use the center color usually. I kind of just go around. Now, because of the lighting, you might not be able to see how good this is, but it's good. It's honestly everything. It's so pretty. And I can kind of get away with using a lot of this. So you guys see how pretty that is? Oh my gosh, I'm obsessed. So sometimes I'll even take this and I'll go around and I'll put that on my eye. So anybody who ever thinks I'm wearing eyeshadow, I guarantee this is all I do. And right there. And I don't worry about it. Now, if you like a cream product or you like a really bright product, you can take this. This is the color of that product. And it would be perfectly acceptable to like add that on top. It's a moussey texture. And they're the same color. So, I mean, I'm not even gonna lie. You can't even tell the difference once I put it on my skin. You can't tell the difference. But you can see on here, it's just like I said, a moussey texture, but it's like the same color, you know? So you could do this, you could not do this. It doesn't really matter. It's gonna look the same, but I do like kind of going in sometimes with both, and then sometimes I'll just pick one or the other. So that's what we have going for the blush. Next, I'm going in with highlighter. I have been using this highlighter for a few years now, and it's barely even has a dent in it. Like, it's so good. It looks white, I know. But this is called the Highlight 01 Matte Radiance Baked Powder. And I use this Laura Mercier fan brush for it. I wish I had a discount code for you guys. Maybe I'll get one, but I just genuinely love all Laura Mercier's products. Look at that. Okay, I don't have it on this side, but I have it on this side. And it basically mimics the same look that you would get if you were sitting in direct sunlight, or if you were like, your skin was slightly dewy or something. And so I just kind of dust it here, and you guys see that? So pretty. So, I don't know. That's what it looks like. It's good. It's a good product. I've used it for a while. I'll be using it for the next probably like 5 years, so yeah. I am gonna go in with lashes. I won't touch on lashes because I only use one lash. I guess I will touch on it. This is the mascara that I love. It's from Kier Weiss. It's so pretty. Such a good mascara. But I always go in with some type of lash extension or something. So I just look at how pretty the packaging is for this. You know, I love red. I love red. So this is Kier Weiss mascara. And if you haven't heard of Kier Weiss, you need to look them up. Such a fabulous brand, based out of Copenhagen, I believe. And just does a really good job. So anyways, when it comes to false eyelashes, for the past 3.5 years, I think I've been using the same lashes, and I'm planning on relaunching the brand for this, but these are part two lashes that I use. So I think we still have the Instagram up, but I did deactivate the website because I need to make some tweaks to it and figure some things out. But these are the only lashes I've been using for the past 3 years. So yeah, and these are called the Jocelyn Lash. So I don't really like talking about it because you can't really buy them. But they're just really good mink lashes, and I'll put them on somewhere in the video. For lips, I'm going to use a lip liner. This is Makeup Forever Limitless Brown. This is the Charlotte Tilbury one. I'll show you. It's a little bit darker. This is the blush that you saw me use. It's Kaja Beauty Whipped Dream Mocha Tarte is the color. So 04 Mocha Tarte is the color. This is the blush. You can use it on your eyes, and then you can use it on your lips like I'm going to. So I'm gonna show you that now. It's so good. Do you see this color? But obviously I'm not gonna leave it like this, okay? So what I'm gonna do now so good. So you can do this with either an eyeshadow brush, or you could be like me and use your finger. So we're just going around in this color out here, saturating my finger with it. My fingers are covered in makeup at this point. But, I mean, you see it. I know you see it. Use your finger, you can use a brush, it literally does not matter. How perfect. I love it. Let's put some eyelashes on, and then I will come right back. All right guys, so here is the final makeup look. I hope you like it. Let me scoot back so you can see it without the shadows. I think it looks so pretty. And this is basically how I do my makeup essentially every single day. So if you like it and you want more makeup tutorials, I can try to do more. But this is my quintessential everyday makeup look. It does not really change or vary whatsoever. And yeah, so if you want to see more videos like this, or you just want to see more of my face, then like, comment, subscribe, and I will talk to you guys very, very soon. I'm going to drink my lychee martini. I'm currently staying at the Nobu Hotel in Chicago, and it's so good. And one of my favorite things is that you can just go downstairs and be at Nobu in like 5 seconds. So yeah, I will talk to you guys very, very soon. Bye.